Right, we've got the boys here from Manchester's Fight Factory. We're over here at Salford City Boxing Academy. Sean Crew with us here, Sean Fennell over there, Stephen Daniel. Yes,
sir. Are you okay? You okay?
Yeah, good man, good to see you. Some good work they're putting in by the boys today.
Yeah, you know, as you know yourself, you don't get this work done, and we don't always, sometimes we also travel because my boxers are guys like Stephen. He's been all over the world with boxing, even us together. So we get used to going to other gyms, different environments. So sometimes it feels a bit hostile, like going here to Gary. You know what Gary's like, motor mouth.
Well, I thought you and Gary was going to get into it as well.
Yeah. I was thinking about it, but I just thought about his age. Hey, Gary, I thought about your age when I was going to get.
I thought you two was going to go at it, you and Sean.
He's alright. You won't have 2 fucking minutes with me anyway. none of them boys will.
Yeah. Stephen, do you enjoy that sparring today?
Oh yeah, it's good work. Always good to go around and spar different guys. So yeah, it's good part of it.
Tell us a little bit about what's going on for you next, Stephen. And obviously your last fight didn't go as you planned, but you went all the way to Quebec.
Yes.
And there's no shame in that. So tell us a little bit about what's going on with you at the minute.
I think it was a good experience. Obviously, I'm short, but me and my team sat down and I really outgrew welterweight. So moving up now to super welterweight, I will be successful in that weight class, because even in the amateurs I was fighting 69 kilograms, and that's obviously welterweight. But with the training and nutrition with Sean Crew, it went good. But obviously me, as I'm getting older as well, I'm 29 years old now, my body's settling down, and no excuses though. It's a good competitive fight, but we're looking on bigger and better things now in the super welterweight division.
Yeah.
We're looking at a fight we have planned a fight on the 2nd of November on the Ultimate Boxer in London. I'm looking really forward to that. And Sean, we as a team got an offer to fight in South Africa. At home, where Sean is from also. So it's good going over there. It will be potentially for a belt, and good opponent, good rating. So I'm looking forward to come home and leave with a belt.
I mean, you were always a big welterweight, weren't you? So maybe it just was naturally time, wasn't it?
It was naturally time.
Yeah. And Sean, I mean, you're looking forward to this new sort of chapter with Stephen, sort of moving
definitely
up in weight and all that sort of stuff. Ultimate Box is a great show as well. I know you've got a bit of involvement with the setup there.
Yes.
Are you looking forward to that one?
No, definitely. And it's good to get Stephen out now, especially it's actually worked very well for us, because Stephen was just going to have because he's been inactive since we've been back from Canada. And I said, let's get him out on that show. And then over the last 2 weeks, we've got that offer from South Africa on Real Steel Promotion show with Andre Taiser. So the opponent is potentially Imani Colombo. He is 11-0, 11 knockouts, 11 wins. Yeah. So I think you remember the show where Stacey Copeland was on in Zimbabwe.
Yeah, Zimbabwe, yeah.
He beat the MTK fighter.
That's right.
In the second round stoppage.
Yeah, that's right.
So that's Stephen's opponent. So he'll be hometown favorite, but it's back in my neck of the woods. So we do carry a bit of weight there,
So all about you and the South Africa, don't you worry.
So we'll have all the family and friends coming to support us, and obviously Stephen's family. So Stephen's family originates from Ghana. So it's a nice welcoming going home for him himself too. So once Stephen gets his rating, he's rated number 71. We're chasing his rating and the belt, obviously too, but his rating is very important to us, because that gets us back into the world scene.
Yeah.
And it's opportunity. I've been trying to convince Stephen for the last 2-3 weeks now that we need something to get back in, and this is a blessing, because it's just come at the right time. Stephen's got to make one assault. We're planning, we always plan 2-3 years ahead. And this last 2 years was a good run. Getting the WBO belt, and then we've been around different, at one point we were working with Queensbury Promotions, and then we went to Canada and everything else. For certain reasons, things didn't work out, and that was a learning experience that we went to Canada. But now we've got to grab this with both hands. Mm-hmm. It's a very risky fight.
It is, by the sounds of it, yeah. But
very,
you know,
risky.
You've always
very
traveled,
good.
You've always gone, you know, you've always not been afraid to take a risk, have you really?
Yeah, very good fight. And I think all Stephen's other fights leading up to this has prepared him for this. Yeah. I mean, Damien Durant is the trainer in the other corner. So it's like, you know, this, it's family.
Yeah.
It's family. And there's no need. They're very, two very good fighters at a crucial stage of both their careers. So it will mean a lot to both of them. And there's no need to for trash talking, because it's like, you know, we both come out of Nick Durant's stable. So his son and myself have traveled all over the world. So I'm looking forward to it. But unfortunately, this is a boxing business. So if something's been offered to us and we feel that it can get us back into the stage where we belong, then we've got to take it with both hands. Yeah. And I know Stephen is hungry. Yeah. And you know, when someone's as hungry as Stephen, where he felt that at last he let that go in a certain way, and it was an experience for us, then he's got to fix things up, you know. And he's a dangerous man when he's in that mood. Mm. A very dangerous man. I remember with the Jurawski fight down in Southampton.
It
was one of those situations or scenarios where when you play somebody that's that determined and that hungry in a position where he feels it's do or die, then I know what's going to happen with him. And I like getting him in that position. And this scenario is exactly the same, where he feels he's pushed into a position where he's got to have it.
Yeah.
You know?
And talking of hungry, now you're moving up in weight, Stephen. You can eat a bit more, can't you?
No, that's not the case. The thing is that I'll be comfortable at the weight. I'll feel strong, because I always felt strong at super welterweight. And, you know, it's do or die for me. You know, I've traveled all over the world, been to different gyms, see a lot of people. But my team, we're doing good work now. So let's keep it that way, and up to bigger and better things.
All right, man. We're looking forward to seeing you.
Thank you.
You know,
thank
as always, I'm sure you'll be back stronger and better.
Yes.
And looking forward to seeing you at super welterweight.
Yes, sir.
Appreciate your time, boys.
All right,
you know the score. Ha ha ha.